at your fantasy. When you go down, down below, do you see what fills your eyes? Is it pretty like a rainbow? Tell me when I scream, do you feel the echo? So when I scream, do you feel the echo?
What's up, everyone? So welcome back to the channel on What It Is. And like we say, conversation without borders, opinions without borders. I get to hang out today with a super sexy, sweet sister. All the S's you can think about, she's here. Even though her name doesn't start with an S, we'll go for the D. Dakwa live on Jay Foley on TV. What's up, girl? How you doing?
Jay, my name is Dakwa.
Yeah, Dakwa. I just said Dakwa, right?
You said Dakwa live.
No, I said Dakwa.
You said Dakwa live.
I played this tape back and you see I said Dakwa. I mean, Dakwa is live on Jay Foley on TV. she's pulling my legs. But how you doing? How's everything?
Charlie, I'm easy. But I'm surviving.
You know, I hear people say it's hard, it's hard. What exactly is the hard thing?
For me, what is hard is stress. I don't like stress, Jay. Jay, I'm a soft baby.
What exactly is the
stress?
Yes, what causes it?
Jay, you know what I do.
Tell me.
You know I do music.
Yes, you do music.
The back-to-backs. Having to be here, do this. This Jesse will call you. You have to do this. This I'll call you. You have to do this. Have you finished doing this?
Do you feel at a certain point that this is a wrong business?
Not at all.
What makes you feel like that?
Because it keeps getting better each day.
What exactly is the better?
You keep getting into a new level each day.
Like
new levels. There's some things I can't say right now.
So break it out. What are those levels? Because I hear a lot of upcoming artists say these things, you know, like either they say it's the hustle or they say, yeah, they see improvements. Mm-hmm. What exactly is it? Addition of more Twitter numbers or Facebook numbers, or what exactly is that thing that makes you
your
say, like,
your music having a wider reach, reaching a wider audience, getting to more people?
Uh-huh.
Say 2 weeks ago,
yeah,
and now,
yeah,
the amount of people my music have gotten to,
okay,
as at now, there's a huge gap.
Okay,
between last two weeks ago and now.
Would you rate that over 50% or under 50% in terms of like the gap? Right?
Over 50%.
Over 50%.
Yeah.
Do you think you did something different that made them, maybe made you get new audience?
Honestly, I don't know what exactly it is, but then I would say hard work from my team.
Mm.
They are really working to push me out there. And
did you do any different kind of music from, what was the last song, the jam you dropped before your new one? So hold on. So by the way, we'll be playing the new song that she's dropped. It's titled Echo. Even though you played this video like 10 years from today, on this day, it's Echo. That's the new song. So you're going to check it out. We're going to play it out. But what was the song you dropped before Echo?
Title was You.
You
was should I say High Life? It sounded like High Life. High Life was in there a bit.
Was it a deliberate choice to go on that rhythm? Like,
honestly, I wasn't planned at all the genre I wanted to do. All I know is, okay, I got this melody,
mm-hmm,
and then the producer came with something. I'm like, okay, this sounds good, I like it.
If it was good in the next song you released, which was Echo, mm-hmm, why didn't you go on that same rhythm?
I'm not known as a high life person. I'm not known as someone who does high life music.
Let's raise this conversation about high life. You know, I've been championing this conversation about high life for a while and saying that high life is the way to go for every single Ghanaian artist. Do you believe that?
I mean, that's our route. So even if it's not the way to go for something, at least you can tap into it once in a while.
Why wouldn't you want to be a high life artist?
Jay, it's just not my thing.
Don't you feel that Ghanaian musicians owe it a right to protect the legacy of Ghanaian music? So for example, do you feel that the artists that came before you, maybe the artists in the 80s,
mm-hmm,
didn't pass on music, the legacy of Ghanaian music properly to, mm-hmm, a new generation?
I wouldn't say they didn't pass it on properly. I mean, it's all about preferences.
Mm.
Yeah, it's a legacy, but if that is not what I want to do, you can't force it down my throat.
In some few years to come, we probably wouldn't be talking about High Life again.
Yeah.
And that's where we've lost it.
sad, but
yeah. There's nothing you can do about it. She's like, that's it. It's like, it's not my headache, is it? Like, what has been some of the most challenging moments in your entire music life?
I would say the most challenging was from when I started. I had no idea. All I thought was, okay, you go into the studio, you record your music, you put it out, and everyone just comes for your music. I didn't know you had to do the pushing. You had to place your music here. You have to send emails. You have to reach out to people. Yeah. I had no idea that was how it worked. So in the beginning, I would say it was really tough.
Okay.
Because I was like, okay, I've recorded a song. It's nice. Why are people not listening? Why are they not playing it? But yeah, right now I'm okay.
Is it any different being female?
Is it?
Is it any different? Is it tougher? Is it easier?
It's easy and tough.
Okay, explain. Break it down.
It's easy because once you're a female, a lot of people want to do you favors. They're like, oh, you're so pretty. So yeah, oh, I want to. Oh, I love your skin. Oh, you're so pretty. I love you.
So how do you draw the line between the people who are being lustful in terms of?
Yes, we're getting there.
How do you draw the line? How do you do it? What do you do when you realize that this isn't the, but you probably still need that platform or the person?
I'm a very straightforward person. If I see an approach that I'm not comfortable with, I let you know, okay, so this thing you're trying to do for me, if these are your intentions, well, I'm letting you know I am not interested.
Share an experience.
I would say it's from a fellow musician.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, I like you.
Ouch.
I see that you're good. We can make good music together. I have a lot of connects, blah, 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 blah. And oh, yeah, you're pretty and I want to help you.
Ouch.
Uh-huh. So I was like, okay, true, this person has connects.
Yeah.
Do I really want the TNCs it's coming with? Because I'm not interested in whoever.
This would be an established artist, like somebody who has grounding in the industry.
Yes. Some of them you can find your way through, some too.
So in this case, what did you do?
I lost both.
You cut it off?
I cut both off. Because it was like, okay, if you're not willing to be with me, then I'm sorry, I can't help you.
How does that make you feel?
Sometimes I question myself that most of the time when people are like, they come and they're like, I want to help you. Do they really want to help, or do they want to help because they want something from me? So maybe, I don't know. I can't accept something that I'm not comfortable with.
Mm-hmm.
No matter what it is you're bringing, if I don't want it, I don't want it. I don't mind losing it. It will hurt me, but you can go.
Okay, let me just talk about, before I wrap up, let me talk about Echo now. Tell us about that song, the new music. Yeah, tell us
my
about it.
My mother is watching.
Yes, it's... The song is dope. Have you listened to the lyrics of the song? Tell us about the lyrics of the song. What were you trying to say in there?
Oh, I'm so... The place is hot. Oh, but all I was saying is, women shouldn't feel shy telling their partners how they want to feel during sexual intercourse. I've come across so many tweets and TikTok videos of women venting, this guy is not really good. I wish he had done it this way. Why didn't you tell him?
Communication.
Like, what was stopping you? Why did you come out to rant?
Would you ask your partner
how he
wants his intimacy?
Yeah, I mean, you should be open. The person is your partner. If you are not comfortable enough or you can't have such conversations, why is the person your partner?
So what if your partner is going extreme, like bondage and stuff like that?
Hey, dear. Take it easy.
Do you feel the echo? Do you feel the echo? So that's what the song talks about.
That's what it's about. Like,
the making
confident
of the song.
Enough to have such conversations with your partner.
What did it take to make the song?
I watched a movie.
Okay.
50 Shades.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Now you see the inspiration, right?
Yeah, 50 Shades. I was like, okay, I can write about this. I'm always writing about love.
Yeah.
Heartbreak. Mm-hmm. Something. Life. Yeah.
But this time around,
like, I can do this.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, let me challenge myself. Let me do it. At first, I was like, hey, my mother, I think I'm a bad girl.
I was just about to ask.
But then, I'm like, it's music. You have to be creative with the music.
Has she heard it?
Oh, she loves it. It's...
Has she listened to it?
I don't know if she has listened.
But she's heard it.
But she's heard it.
Song is out on all platforms, I believe, right?
Yeah, everywhere.
Darko, it's been great having you.
Thank you for having me, Jay.
On that note, do you feel the echo? Check it out.